This is Coding Math, Application 3, Ballistics, Part 3. So we're working on a little game here where you aim a gun and shoot it, and eventually we'll get it so you can try to hit a target. Now so far we've gotten the aiming and the shooting down, and the cannonball moves with a decently realistic path. But right now the cannon is a single-strength machine. It fires all the cannonballs at the same force. So let's see if we can do something about that. Now in some casual shooting games you'll see a sort of oscillating power meter. It sits there going up and down or back and forth, and you have to shoot at just the right time to get the amount of power you want. Kitty Cannon, which is an old flash game that's still around, is a classic example of this kind of power meter. I don't necessarily love this kind of mechanism, but let's create one, if only as an experiment. Now, if you watch the episodes on trigonometry, you're hopefully thinking that oscillation is nicely done with a sine wave. So we'll have some kind of angle variable that will continually increase by some amount. We'll take the sine of that, and that'll give us a number from minus 1 to plus 1. Now that's a value and a range. We can then use the map function we created back in mini number 3 to map that value to a new range. And we'll use the result of that to draw a rectangle representing the current power level. Then we'll use map again to map that original sine value to yet another range, and use that value to set the length of the cannonball's velocity vector. So a nice use of trig and one of our utility functions. Now I realize there's a problem here. The power meter is going to need to be continuously redrawn as that sine wave changes. That means a request animation frame update loop. Now we have one of those already, but it only runs when the cannonball is moving. So we'll need to re-architect this game a bit. What we'll do is we'll change this update loop so that it's always running by moving the request animation frame line out of the else statement. But now that means that the cannonball is always going to be updated, and we don't want that. So we'll wrap that in a line that checks an isShooting flag. Then we'll create that flag up at the top of the file here and initialize it to false. Then in the shoot function, we'll set it to true. And finally, back in the update function, we'll set it to false once the cannonball has hit the ground. Now it bothers me that we have a can shoot variable and an is shooting variable, and they're basically just the inverse of each other. I think we can get rid of the can shoot, and then we can just check if not is shooting to determine whether or not we can fire another shot. Okay, the only thing left is in the aim gun function. Since we're continuously drawing anyway, we can remove this call to update. And we'll also need to kick off the update function by calling it up at the top of the file here instead of draw. Let's just test this to make sure we didn't break anything yet. Okay, this still seems to work. Now it may not look any different, but right now it's redrawing the whole screen on every frame. Now that's fine for a simple game like this where there isn't that much to draw anyway. But in a game with more complex graphics, you'd have to get a lot more sophisticated about what you draw when. Now back to the code. We'll add a force angle variable here and we'll set it to 0, and a force speed variable and set it to 0.1, and a raw force variable set to 0. Now down in update, we'll just add force speed to force angle on every frame. Now force angle is constantly increasing, and we'll set raw force to the sine of force angle. So raw force will constantly oscillate from minus 1 to plus 1. Now down in the draw function, we want to draw a rectangle that represents the current value of raw force. First, we'll draw out a full-size rectangle as a background. We'll draw it down here at, say, 10 pixels on X, and height minus 10 on Y. The width will be 20 pixels, and the height will be negative 100. Canvas allows you to draw negative rectangles this way. Then we'll draw a slightly darker rectangle on top of that. The XY width will be the same, but the height will be in a range from 0 pixels to minus 100. So we have a value, raw force, which is in a range of minus 1 to plus 1, and we want to map that to a range of 0 to minus 100 for the height of the rectangle. So we can use the map function for that. We plug in the value and the two ranges, and the result of that is the height of the darker rectangle. Let's see how it looks. Okay, cool. We have an oscillating power meter. Now let's use it. So back here in the shoot function, we're setting the cannonball's velocity length to 15. Let's change that to a value within a range, again, mapped from raw force. We'll make the final range something like 2 to 20. Now, as I was planning this out, I came up with a couple of other tweaks I decided to implement. First of all, in the last episode, we set up the fire key to use key up. But now, since it's so time-dependent on where the power meter is at the exact instant you hit the key, I think it's going to be better to use the key down. That's as easy as changing the event we're looking for. Because we're already guarding against multiple shots, that should work just fine. Next, it would be nice to know the actual power you wound up with right after you shot. As is, the power meter will continue to oscillate. If we go into the update function, to that line where force speed is added to force angle, we can wrap this in an if statement that checks not is shooting. Now the meter will only oscillate when it is waiting for you to shoot. During the time the cannonball is in the air, it will display the force that was used to shoot the cannonball. So let's try that. Okay, so we take a few shots, and using the same angle, but we're going to get varying amounts of force depending on when we hit the spacebar. So play around with this and make sure you understand what's going on. See if you can change the speed of the power meter, change how it's drawn, make it horizontal, or maybe have a circular meter instead of a rectangle. Because of the way that raw power is mapped separately to the meter and the final force, you can change the rendering of the meter without affecting the force, or change the force without worrying about the meter. All right, that's all for now. We will see you next week.